you guys. I'm live here from California. I'm in my backyard of my auntie house on her little back patio. Hopefully you guys can hear me good. I usually don't record outside, but there's too many people in the house, and ignore the dogs barking in my background. But I wanted to come to you guys today to have a discussion about a few things. Let me go ahead and share this video. One second. Y'all know the routine. Hey. Thank you guys for joining. Today's topic is gonna be really fun. Hey Tim. I'm just sharing it to my other pages really quick while I'm waiting for more people to join. I have to share it to my group and my business page. And you guys can go ahead and share it. I know like most people will be like, share it out to every page, but you don't have to if you don't want to. But it is gonna be a juicy topic today. Today's topic is, let me go back to it. Hold on one second, y'all. Hey Tish, thanks for joining as always. You always catch me live. I'm just trying to find today's topic. I just had it up. Okay, today's topic, hey Ashley. It's, have you ever been mad or upset at the other parent because they get the freedom of a single person while you have to take on the primary responsibility of raising your child alone? I chose this topic today because a lot of times in the beginning of my whole co-parenting and becoming a mom, like, I didn't choose to be a single mom. And that definitely wasn't my goal, is to be a single mom or a baby mama. Thanks, Tish. So that's why I picked this topic, because a lot of times in the beginning, we couldn't co-parent because I couldn't heal for the simple fact I used to be angry that I'm a single mom, and I used to be offended that I was a single mom. It used to really piss me off because I'm like, I don't deserve to be a single mom. Like, I'm better than that. I am not a baby mama. So, like, even to this day, my son dad is not allowed to call me baby mama. I'm like, you got three other baby mamas that have that title. I'm just your son's mother. But a lot of times, like, we used to follow each other on social media. Now we can't, because I used to get mad at when he was deployed and stationed in Biloxi, Mississippi. Him and his friends used to go out to New Orleans for the weekend partying. I'm like, how you out partying? Your kid need clothes and shoes. But you say you broke, but you out drinking. So I used to get pissed off, like, oh, you out having fun and stuff like that while I'm stuck raising your child by myself. Like, I really used to be in my feelings. And until I got over that, that's when we were able to co-parent. But we just eliminate sharing social media. Like, we do not follow each other still to this day. You had those issues too, Tish? Girl, like, I really used to look at him and be like, you get to have fun. You get to go out and party. I can't do that. You get to go out and do this. I can't do that because I'm stuck home raising your child while you go out and live a single life. Hopping from relationship to relationship and not having to worry about your kids. I said, me and him had a conversation last week where I was talking to him and I was like, we were talking about like how we used to have problems and what the problem really was before we actually healed and forgave each other and stuff like that. And I used to tell him, I used to just be mad that I didn't get to do the stuff you were able to do. And I didn't get to, if you're looking at me through the window, I didn't get to have that single life. I never got to be a single person and stuff because I was right out of a relationship and then I had my son. So it's like I used to, you want to say hi? Here he go, you guys. Y'all can say hi to me. It's only one person on right now, but this is my son, Dad, Davion. You can say hi to him. It's only one person live, Tish, right now.
I just woke up.
I just woke up from a nap, too. I'm sitting outside. It's hot. And this is going to be a short video because I'm going to be back in the house in the air conditioning. It's like 98 degrees right now. But I used to get mad because I'm like, you get to go out and do whatever you want, and I don't have that option. And I'm like, if I don't do it, who else will? And I always had that attitude, like, being angry, because I'm like, you're living your best life. I was 22 when I had my son. So, like, the only thing I had before that was a long-term relationship. So, like, I really used to be angry all the time. And until you actually tackle, like, I seen a quote by T.D. Jakes that says, you can't get over anything that hurt you until you first give up what you had in mind. Because I never had being a single mom in mind, I was in my feelings. I felt like this is not what I wanted. So until I got over that, then I was able to live my best life and be the best mom I can be and get my friend back. And because at the end of the day, we was always friends overall more than anything. So when we took it back to like the friendship, like I know him, he know me. We've been friends since we were like 15 years old. So once I got over like the fact that I was a single mom, then we were able to talk, have a conversation. Then you have to forgive a person. You have to forgive yourself first and get out of that fantasy way of living. Like, oh, this is the way I dreamed to have in my life. Even though your life didn't turn out like that, your life is not over. You can always change that chapter. You can always make it what you want and live your best life. You don't have to have a traditional family and traditional life to be happy. It's all about your kid. It's not about you and what you dreamed of when you were younger. So I always tell people the only way you can get over it is to forgive yourself and get out of that, give up what you thought it was going to be and work with what you have now. Like, you have to start from where you at now. You can't go backwards. You can do not make the same mistake twice. That's why I only have one kid. I'm not going to be a baby mama twice because I already know how that was at the beginning. So, like, I always tell people that. And I did open up my calendar for July to be able to help those, because some people need help getting over that forgiving part and getting out of that stuck area where you're just like beating yourself up because you're in that position. So if you need help with that, you can always book your 45-minute free breakthrough call with me, and we can go through it together. That's part of my co-parenting program. I know a lot of people do want to co-parent, but they just don't know how or where to start. We can have that conversation where we can get you on board with that starting point. There are some people that don't need co-parenting, but they just need help with, they don't have the option to co-parent. They just need help with being a single parent. I also help you with that. I have one-on-one sessions that are open. I have 4 more slots for the month of July. You can either press email on my website that's in the link above, or you can message me to get on the calendar, get your free 45-minute session. And we can have a conversation so I can meet you where you're at now, and we can build a program or plan going from that point forward to see if co-parenting is even needed for you, or if you just need to have a conversation with someone to help you get out of that stuck area where you just need to know where to move forward from that point. But I do have some people that can work it out on their own and communicate and don't need a coach to do every step for them. You can do the co-parenting contract that I have available on my website, which is above in the link. Or, I know your child is worth $7 investment. You can download my guide to co-parenting like a boss. This is a first step. It will teach you different steps on how to forgive, what questions to ask the person, to be able to see where to start with building a parenting plan. You don't always have to have someone to guide you through if you're adult enough to have that conversation and be able to communicate with each other without arguing. That's when the coach come in and be the mediator to help you go through that forgiveness, that hurt. Because sometimes we can be mad, but we don't ever think about how the other parent feel. So it's like, I always ask, like, how do you feel about the situation? Or, like, you have to ask the other person, because they might feel like you just don't care about how they feel about their child or what they want for their child, because you're not on the same page. You're so hurt or mad that you can't even get that far to thinking about the other person is being selfish and only thinking about yourself. So it's like you have to give that person the opportunity to speak their mind too. But if you're not willing to open up and listen, co-parenting is never going to work. next week, I think I might do another video for those who, because I have had a few people reach out to me about narcissistic partner. You cannot co-parent with a narcissistic partner, but there is another type of parenting. It's called parallel parenting. It's similar to co-parenting, but instead you have to literally cut off all communication, and everything is have to be in a controlled environment, in a controlled situation where you're dealing with someone that's narcissistic. They're intentionally hurting you. They're intentionally turning your kids against you. They have to raise the kids separate different households, separate different rules. So that's called parallel parenting. I am going to help a few people that have reached out to me that have had problems co-parenting because the other partner is like intentionally doing stuff to hurt them, and they're really narcissistic and not thinking about the child first. But there is a possibility of co-parenting. It's just you have to do it in a systematic way, and it's a little more difficult, but at the end of the day you still will be able to co-parent. So I will go live with that later, but I just wanted to share with you guys, it's not impossible to co-parent. If I can do it, you can do it. Simple as that. But I just want you guys to have fun. I'm still on vacation. I'll be back on tomorrow or Wednesday. So go ahead and reach out to me so you guys can get on my schedule. I'll free up some time this week to be able to speak to a few people. And I have a lot of people to follow up with. I'm sorry, you guys. I've been busy with family and enjoying California. Even though it's hot, I think I brought the biggest heat to California. But I definitely will be reaching out to some of those who have already reached out to me and getting you on the schedule, as well as following up with the people that I've already talked to so that they can get on the schedule now that it's back open. Now the vacation time is over. It's time to get back to business. And I thank you guys and appreciate you for tuning in. Hopefully this video wasn't too bad. I don't know about the reception, but it was a weak signal. But I really appreciate you guys, and I'm going to come live again sometime this week, probably with my family, because all of them are going to be in Vegas. We're going to be supporting my little cousins at their basketball tournament for 4 days this week, so we all come out to support. But I thank you guys, and thanks for tuning in, and hope to hear from some of you guys. Hey Keisha, if you are missing this, you can catch the replay. Just do hashtag replay. And I just wanted to keep this video short for the simple fact, like, I'm not at home. I have unstable Wi-Fi right now. But I really appreciate you guys. Hey, Brittany. But if you're replaying this, just do hashtag replay so I can know you checked in. And thank you guys for listening. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.